नमो नमः सुस्वागतम स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन विद अ न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ ग्रामर दैट इज संधि इन प्रीवियस स्टैंडर्ड वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड स्वर संधि एंड दिस ईयर वी आर गोइंग टू गेट एक्वेंटेड विद सम इम्पॉर्टेंट काइंड्स ऑफ व्यंजन संधि एंड विसर्ग संधि लेट मी गिव यू अ क्विक रिकैप ऑन वॉट वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट द बेसिक्स रिलेटेड टू संधि What is sandhi? The change that occurs as a result of joining of two letters coming into close contact with each other is called sandhi. For example, Ramah plus Tatha. The sandhi is Ramas Tatha. Here, visarg has got changed into halant sa. As a change has taken place here, it's the example of sandhi. So basically, sandhi is all about the change that occurs in letters when two or more words are joined together. There are three main kinds of sandhi. Swara sandhi, which is based on vowels. It is also known as ach sandhi. Vyanjan sandhi, which is based on consonants, which is known as hal sandhi as well. And visarga sandhi, which is related to visarga. We have already studied some kinds of swara sandhi and this year we are going to learn some types of vyanjan sandhi and visarga sandhi. So let's start with vyanjan sandhi. Vyanjan sandhi. The change that occurs in a consonant when it is followed by a vowel that is swaraha or vyanjanam that is a consonant is called vyanjan sandhi. This year we are going to learn the two rules of vyanjan sandhi jashtva sandhi and the rule of anunasik sandhi so let's start with the first one that is jashtva sandhi but before that I would like to discuss a few things about vyanjanani that is consonants so students as vyanjan sandhi is based on consonants it is necessary to revise first sanskrit consonants and their classification Here is the table. Have a look at that. This table acquaints us about the kathora varnaha, mrudu varnaha, vargiya vyanjanani and avargiya vyanjanani. As you can see, there are five classes of consonants. Ka vargaha, cha vargaha, ta vargaha, ta vargaha and pa vargaha. Each class consists of five consonants. For example, ka varga consists of k kh g gh ng cha varga has cha ch j j ny the consonants which belong to ta varga are t th d dh n ta varga has t th d th n and pa varga consists of p f b b m So thus, 25 class consonants are there. Besides these, there are 8 consonants which do not belong to any class. They are given in the last row of the table. Sh, sh, s, y, r, l, v, h. As they don't belong to any varga, they are called avargiyaha. They are avargiya varnaha. So 25 class consonants and 8 non-class consonants. Thus, we have got 33 consonants in all. Further, these consonants are divided into two parts. Kathora varnaha and mrudu varnaha. Hard consonants and soft consonants. Hard consonants require a little effort for their pronunciation than others. And the remaining three of each class, which are known as soft consonants, mrudu vyanjanani, and they are mrudu because they need relatively less effort for their pronunciation. So as you can see, the first two class consonants of each varga are kathora varnaha. K, kh, ch, ch, t, th, t, th, p, f, and sh, sh, s. Whereas the mrudu varnaha are g, gh, ng, j, j, ny, d, dh, n, द ध न ब भ म एंड य र ल व ह सो दिस इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट because it is going to help you out to understand jashtva sandhi. So let's start with jashtva sandhi. Jashtva sandhi naam vargiya prathama varnasya tritiya varne parivartanam. Vargiya prathama varnaha means the first letter of the class, and tritiya varnaha naam the third letter of the class. So the rule is, when the first letter of the class, that is prathama varnaha, is followed by any swaraha, that is vowel, or mrudu vyanjanam, soft consonant, then the prathama varna is replaced with the tritiya varnaha, that is the third letter of the class. I'll repeat, when the first letter of the class is followed by a vowel or a soft consonant, then it is replaced with the third letter of the same class. Let me elaborate the concept. Ka, cha, ta, ta, and pa. These are the first letters of the five classes. When these letters are followed by any vowel or a soft consonant, mrudu vyanjana, then they are replaced with the third letter of the same class which they belong to. Let's try to understand with the help of a table. We have just seen this table. Ka, cha, ta, ta, pa are the first class consonants, and when they are followed by swar or vyanjan, they are replaced with the third letter of the class. What is the third letter of ka varga? Ga. The third letter of cha varga is ja. The third letter of ta varga is da. Of ta varga, da. And of pa varga, ba. It means, when ka, cha, ta, ta, pa is followed by swar or mrudu vyanjan, ka is replaced with ga, cha is replaced with ja, ta is replaced with da, ta is replaced with da, and pa with ba. Let's try to understand with the help of some examples. The first example is vak plus arthi. You can see that vak ends with halant ka, and the next word is beginning with a, which is a vowel. So as per the rule of jashtva sandhi, ka is replaced with ga. Ka is replaced with ga. So vag plus arthi. And when we join these two, we get the word vagarthi. Got it? Let's see one more example. Dik plus gajaha. The sandhi is diggajaha. How we have got this sandhi? Dik ends with ka, gajaha begins with ga. It is a soft consonant. It is a mrudu vyanjan. So, ka is replaced with ga. Ka is replaced with halant ga. So, these get joined, get combined together, and we get the word diggajaha. Diggajaha. The next example is ach plus antaha. Ach ends with cha. The next word is beginning with a. So cha is replaced with the third letter of the class, that is ja. The third letter of the class, ja. So aj plus antaha. And when we join these two, we get the word ajantaha. The next example is shat plus ananaha. Ta is followed by a, a vowel. So, ta is replaced with da. It is replaced with da. So, we get the next step as shad plus ananaha. And when we join these two, we get the sandhi shadananaha. One more example. Sat plus dharmaha. The sandhi is saddharmaha. Ta is replaced with da. Why? Because ta is followed by dha of dharmaha, which is a soft consonant. So ta is replaced with halant da, and sad plus dharmaha together make the word saddharmaha. Up plus jaha. Pa is the first letter of the class. Ja is a soft consonant. So pa is replaced with ba. And अब प्लस जह फॉर्म द वर्ड अब जह. सो क इज रिप्लेस्ड विथ ग और च इज रिप्लेस्ड विथ ज. ट इज सब्स्टिट्यूटेड बाय ड. त इज बाय द एंड प इज रिप्लेस्ड विथ ब. दिस चेंज इज कॉल्ड जश्त्व संधि. गॉट इट? चेंजिंग द फर्स्ट लेटर ऑफ द क्लास टू द थर्ड वन. स्टूडेंट्स, आई वॉन्ट यू टू टेक अ नोट ऑफ एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट हियर दैट यू डोंट हैव टू राइट द स्टेप्स वाइल मेकिंग संधि. द स्टेप्स विच आर गिवन हियर आर जस्ट फॉर योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. यू डोंट नीड टू राइट एनी स्टेप, जस्ट मेक अ संधि एंड राइट द आंसर. गॉट इट? लेट्स सी सम मोर एग्जाम्पल्स. सम्यक प्लस उक्तम, द संधि इज सम्यगुक्तम. अच प्लस वर्णः, द संधि इज अज्वर्णः. षट प्लस दर्शनम, द संधि इज षड्दर्शनम. जगत प्लस ईशः इज जगदीशः. एंड ल्यप प्लस अंतम इज ल्यबंतम. I hope how to make jashtva sandhi is understood by you. Now let's see how to do the sandhi vichhed of jashtva. Students, sandhi vichhedaha or the dissolution of sandhi is to separate words which are joined, right? But many students find sandhi vichhed difficult. So let me help you for that. Every sandhi has a letter or two in it which can help us to identify the exact point at which we are supposed to separate the words. We can call these letters as splitting points. So now, let's try to understand the sandhi vichhedaha of jashtva sandhi with the help of these splitting points. While doing the sandhi vichhed, we need to find out the splitting points, right? And in jashtva sandhi, the splitting points are the letters G, J, D, D and B. It means you need to find out these letters in the given words and they will help you out as the splitting point to separate the words. Here, the words are given for Sandhi Vichhed and for your understanding, I have written the splitting points, that is these letters, by separating them from the vowels which they are with. For example, the first is Vagishah. So, gi is showing us that it has the letter g and e. Ajadihi, it has the splitting point j with the vowel a. Samradayam, we can see the letter d here, but it is a complete letter, so it has the vowel a with it. Mahadukham, halantada is the splitting point, it doesn't have any vowel with it. Subantaha, B is with the vowel A here. So the halant G, J, D, D and B, these are the splitting points which we have found in these given examples. Now, while doing the Sandhi Vichhed, we need to reverse the process. Previously, we have changed K into G, Ch into J, T into D, T into D and P into B. Now, when we are going to reverse it, it means in Sandhi Vichhed, we are going to change G into K, J into Ch, D into T, D into T and B into P. We are changing the third letter into the first letter. When we are doing the Sandhi Vichhed, we are changing the third letter into the first one. So thus we get the answers. Vagishah, the Sandhi Vichhed is Vak plus Ishah. Ajadihi, the Sandhi Vichhed is Ach plus Adihi. Samradayam, the Sandhi Vichhed is Samrat plus Ayam. Mahadukham, the Sandhi Vichhed is Mahat plus Dukham. And Subantaha, the Vichhed is Sup plus Antaha. As you can see, in all these examples, when Sandhi Vichhed is done, the third letter
is replaced with the first one.
Students, assuming that you have understood jashtva sandhi, now I'm taking you to the next type of vyanjan sandhi, anunasik sandhi. Anunasik sandhi is related to anunasik varnaha, which means nasal letters. The last consonant of each class is known as nasal consonant because their pronunciation is done through the nose. For example, here in ka varga, the last letter is ng. The last letter of cha varga is nya. The last letter of ta varga is n. Of ta varga n and pa varga m. These five letters ng, nya, na, na, ma are known as anunasik varnaha or nasals. And anunasik sandhi is based on these nasals. Now let's try to understand the rule. So anunasik sandhi is about vargiya prathama varnasya panchama varne parivartanam. It means when the first letter of any class is followed by a nasal, that is anunasik varnaha, then the first letter of the class is replaced with the fifth letter, that is the panchama varnaha of the same class. I'll repeat. If the first letter of any class is followed by a nasal, then the first letter of the class is replaced by the nasal belonging to that class. What does it mean? Let's try to understand. So as we can see in the table, the letters ka, cha, ta, ta and pa are the first letters of each class. When these letters are followed by any anunasik varnaha, that is nga, nya, na, na or ma, any one of these letters, then the letter ka is replaced with the last letter of the same class. What is the last letter of ka varga? Ka, kha, ga, gha and ng. So the letter ka is replaced with the anunasik varna ng. Cha is replaced with the anunasik varna which belongs to cha varga, that is nya. Ta is replaced with na, as it is the last letter of the same class. Ta is replaced with na because na belongs to ta varga. And pa is replaced with ma. Thus, the rule says, when the first letter of any class, that is ka, cha, ta, ta or pa, is followed by any anunasik varnaha, then the first letter of the class, that is ka, is replaced with nga, cha is replaced with nya, ta is replaced with na, ta with na and pa with ma. I hope you have understood the rule. Now let's try to understand it in detail with the help of some examples. The first example is vak plus mayam. In this one, the first word ends with the letter K and it is followed by a word which is beginning with the letter M. To make it easier to understand, I have just written the letter M here. It is the anunasik varnaha. So the rule says, when K is followed by anunasik varnaha, it should be replaced with NG. So K is replaced with NG. And thus we get the word vangmayam. So vak plus mayam, the sandhi is vangmayam. Let's see one more example. Shat plus mukha. The word shat ends with ta and it is followed by the word which is beginning with the letter ma. As ma is an anunasik varnaha, so as per the rule, ta will get replaced with na. Na plus mukha, and when we join the two words, we get the sandhi shanmukha. Thus, shat plus mukha, the sandhi is shanmukha. The next example is jagat plus nath. The word jagat ends with ta and it is followed by the word beginning with na. Na is the anunasik varnaha, so ta is replaced with na. And we get the sandhi jagannath. So jagat plus nath, the sandhi is jagannath. Let's see one more example. Up plus mayah. The word up ends with pa and is followed by halant ma. So as per the rule, pa will get replaced with ma. So we get the sandhi ammayah. Up plus mayah, the sandhi is ammayah. I hope examples have made it more clear to you. Here are some more examples of anunasik sandhi. Dik plus nagah, ding nagah. Ka has got changed into nga. Shat plus navatihi, shan navatihi. In this one, ta is replaced with na. Tavat plus me, the sandhi is tavan me. Ta is replaced with na. And the next one is the example of the similar kind of change. Syat plus na, syan na. Students, take note of an important point here. In the example shat plus navatihi, not only the letter ta has got changed into na, but the letter na of navatihi has also been replaced with na. It is because another rule of sandhi is applicable here. For now, you should keep in mind that the sandhi of shat plus navatihi cannot be written as shan navatihi with the letter na of nadi, but it should be written as shan navatihi with the letter na of banah. There is one similar example. Shat plus naam. The wrong way of writing the sandhi is shan naam, but the correct way is shan naam with the letter na. I hope it is clear to you. Now let's see the sandhi vichhedah of anunasik sandhi. It is easy. We just need to identify the anunasik varnaha. Nga, nya, na, na, and ma. Once you get these letters, they will help you as splitting points. And one more thing is, in sandhi, all these letters are used halant or they are joined to the next letter. So it will be easy to understand the remaining half part of the sandhi as well. For example, here in the word Vang Madhura, we can see the letter Nga is there. Once we get the letter Nga, it is easy to identify that the next word of the sandhi is Madhura. The next one is Madhulin Matram. We can see the half Na in the sandhi, so that is the splitting point for us. And the next word is Matram. Mannivasah. Halant Na is identified. And the next word of the sandhi is Nivasah. Can you identify the letter in the next sandhi? Yes, it is Halant Ma. And once you get this letter, it becomes easy to guess the next word. That is Nadi. Now, we have got the splitting points. As we have done earlier, we are supposed to reverse the process here. It means the nasal letters will be replaced with the first letter of the same class. Ng will be replaced with ka, nya with ch, na with t, na with t, and ma with p. And thus we get the answers. Vang Madhura, Vak plus madura. Madulin matram. The sandhi vichhed is madulit plus matram. Mannivasaha. The sandhi vichhed is mat plus nivasaha. And amnadi. The vichhedaha is up plus nadi. So we can conclude it as in sandhi vichhedaha of anunasik sandhihi, find out the nasal letters and replace them with the first letter of the same class. Students, I assume that you have understood how to make and dissolve both jashtva sandhihi and anunasik sandhihi. Now it's the time to solve the questions based on these two. But before we proceed, let's have a quick recap on what we learned today. As per the rule of jashtva sandhihi, when the first letter of any class, that is ka, cha, ta, ta, pa, is followed by any swaraha or mrudu vyanjanam, then the first letter of the class is replaced with the third letter of the same class. That is ka is replaced with ga, cha with ja, ta with da, ta with da, and pa with ba. As per the rule of anunasik sandhihi, when the first letter of the class is followed by any nasal letter or anunasik varnaha, then ka is replaced with nga, cha with nya, ta with na, ta with na, and pa with ma. Students, as the letters which get changed are the same in both jashtva sandhi and anunasik sandhihi, so you may think that it is quite confusing, but it is not, because jashtva sandhi is about the letters ga, ja, da, da, ba, and anunasik sandhihi is about the anunasik varnaha, that is nga, nya, na, na, and ma. If you will keep this thing in mind, then you will never get confused between these two sandhis. So now, are you ready to solve the questions based on these? So let's get started. Here are the questions. Uchitam sandhim chinuta. You need to choose the correct sandhi for the given sandhi vichheds. And the questions are vak plus arthav. The second one is sat plus dharmaha. Third one is ap plus jaha. Fourth one is shat plus netram. And the last one is chit plus mayam. Students, you can pause the video, solve the questions, and then you can move on to the part where the answers will be displayed. I hope you have followed the process, and now I'm going to display the answers. Here are the answers. The answers are displayed in red font. Vak plus arthav. The answer is vagarthav. Sat plus dharmaha, sat dharmaha. Up plus jaha, ab jaha. Shat plus netram, shan netram. And chit plus mayam, the answer is chin mayam. Out of these five, first three are the examples of jashtva sandhihi, and the last two are of anunasik sandhihi. Let's solve one more question. Uchitam sandhi vichhedam chinuta. You need to choose the correct dissolution for the given sandhis. The questions are samradayam. The second one is jagat bandhuhu. The third one is subantaha. Fourth one is dingmoodaha. And the last one is etanna. I hope you all are ready with your answers. So now let me display them. Here are the answers. Samradayam. The dissolution is samrat plus ayam. Jagat bandhuhu. The answer is jagat plus bandhuhu. Subantaha. The answer is sup plus antaha. Dingmoodaha. The answer is dik plus moodaha. And etanna. The sandhi vichhed is etat plus na. I hope your answers are correct.
So students, I would like to end the session here. Keep in mind, margarabdhaha sarvayatnaha phalanti. All the efforts started in the right direction become successful. So keep on practicing. Dhanyavadaha, punah milamaha.